Hey folks, Spirit2 Neil here. Quick video today about the new mapper system that's been put in place. This is built by community members Bones and Duck for the Helium IoT network. So if you haven't used it in a while, mappers has some issues. So it has some graphical bugs and it just doesn't flat out support Chirp Stack right now. And now that's the default way to use the Helium network. It's not possible for new people to contribute to the map. So you might be asking, why map the Helium network? What use is it? Well, it verifies coverage and it allows people to say, you know, if I place a sensor in an area, will I get coverage here? Now, right now, Explorer just shows the resolution 8x of a hotspot, which is not what it's actually covering. So Mappers is a way of verifying what could be simulated. So it's a great system for the network to actually verify coverage and allow people to search their location and see if they could pop a sensor there. Also has a secondary use as well, that you can test your hotspots working. You can test antenna changes, you can test placement changes, you can test cable changes, things like that, and easily see the output and see if it improves. So all a mapper is a GPS unit with a LoRa radio. It gets its GPS position and then it uplinks it. What Mappers does in the background and what's attached to all Helium data in the background is the hotspots that heard it. So if you have max copies set on a device, so that's a setting that says, you know, allow more than one hotspot to hear this, you could map everyone. So, you know, if you're in an area of 100 hotspots and you've got a max copies of 20, the first 20 to respond will show up. So this allows you to take a reading from wherever you are, and it will uplink the GPS data. You will then get the metadata of all the hotspots that have heard it. And the mapper system then takes a resolution 8x and it says, this hex has coverage from these hotspots and it's stored like that. So let's show it off. Okay, so this is it, mappers.hexato.io. So it's an upgraded version of Mappers. As you can see right now, it's quite blank, you know, not many users in the States, a few points here and there. There's most of Eastern Europe has not got any Mappers on it at the moment. There's a few people running around the UK, a few in Amsterdam, and you know, someone's done some very long journeys all over the place. But it's a brand new map, and what you immediately see is there's no graphical glitches, and also when you click on a hex, there isn't any of those graphical glitches that eventually lead to a timeout and errors. So much improved. There's also some extra features, such as if you press Control F, you can search for a location. There we go. And what I really like as well is there's a full statistics page. What's pretty cool is that there's finally a leaderboard for the system. So having that leaderboard just to see how you're doing compared to others is really good. Right now, this is I Love Cows. He's running all over the UK, actually using the network. So he's mapping alongside that as well. So, you know, it's a really good opportunity for you to join a program like this and start mapping the network. If you need help getting going, there's a full docs page on this website. So shows you how to integrate with Chirp Stack to make it work. And you can even, there's two types of integration. One's protobuf and the other one's JSON. Either one works. So there's two different endpoints. And this is a kind of like a suitable uplink. So if you have a device decoder in place with one of these mappers, you'll generally have this decoder in place already. So you just have to make sure that it has these additional fields in it. Otherwise it can't be integrated. If you're lucky to still have a Helium console account, then you could just add this as a new integration and add it to your flow. But in Chirp Stack, you'll need to do an integration into the HTTP integration. And if you already have one set up for the device, you can just add a comma and add it to the list. This doesn't automatically update, so the tile layer for this doesn't update all the time. It updates twice a day. This is kind of a privacy, so you can't see a live mapper on this and you can't work out where a device is or any privacy concerns with that. There's also a lot of work in the background going on about the API and people being able to access this data or use this data in different ways. So it's really been developed out beyond Mappers, and it's great to see. Bones and Duck Tater have done some amazing work here, and it's great to see it happen. I'd love to see this overtake mappers.helium.com eventually. And obviously there's a lot of data there that would be really cool to integrate into this system. And that's it really, that was the video for today. So thanks for watching.